right now, we don't have any community spread. I wouldn't be surprised if we have some community spread within the next 2 to 3 weeks. You know, our healthcare institutions have been preparing for this for well over a month now. Protocols are in place for how to care for folks that have coronavirus. Most people that get coronavirus don't actually get that sick. But what we're needing to do is be thoughtful about who might get more sick and how do we be, how do we take extra caution for those people. And so I think that's where the guidance from the CDC and public health has come out about particularly elderly people are at higher risk of this virus making them very sick. And so that is why people will be hearing about different changes in policies in nursing facilities or even the hospital about visitors and coming and going. The whole idea is to try and decrease the exposure to at-risk populations. Other at-risk populations are people that have chronic diseases like diabetes or heart disease or kidney disease. With any infection, people that are immunocompromised are at risk for that infection. And that makes sense. If somebody's immune system does not work fully, then if they get a new infection, that infection generally has more time to cause problems in their body before their immune system reacts. So I think that would include people that are getting chemotherapy, people that are on chronic steroids, or people that have a known immunodeficiency. You hear it said somebody has a very strong immune system and never gets sick, or they have a weak immune system and they always get sick. And for people that don't have specific reasons to have an immunocompromised status, I would feel that this virus probably isn't any different than any other virus, but it would be a higher risk for people that have a known immunocompromising condition, such as certain medications or certain diseases that would put them at higher risk. I would say that they should probably follow similar recommendations as the CDC has put out for elderly people or people with other chronic conditions as well.